Welcome back, everyone. This is the second video of the series where I show you how I set up my workspace. And in the first video, I've been talking about Photoshop and how I set up the canvas there, how I position my tools, what kind of actions I use, what kind of plugins. So you know what I'm working on in my day-to-day. Welcome back, everyone. This is the second video of this series where I show you how I set up my workspace. In the first one, we've been talking about Adobe Photoshop and how I set up my workspace, how I set up my tools, how I use my plugins, what kind of actions I use. Feel free to check it out if you haven't yet. And also, please share how you set up your Capture One or your Photoshop in the comments. And let us know, so it's very interesting for me and also for the community. And if you haven't yet, please feel free to subscribe to my channel and activate the bell so that you get notified when there is a new video online. And before we get started, I would also like to encourage you to comment and give us your feedback, because that feeds the algorithm and helps this channel to grow, and that would be much appreciated. Thank you so much. And now we're going to switch to Capture One, and I'm going to show you how I set up everything there. As you can see here, this is what Capture One looks like out of the box when you open a session. I usually, as a retouch artist, work only with sessions. I don't use the catalog, but that being said, it has the same functionality, and sessions are just for jobs. So that you can work on single jobs and have it separately in separate folders that you can also send to clients, etc. This is the standard workspace where you have all the different categories like the library, exposure evaluation, everything that has to do with keystoning, cropping, etc. The styles and presets, and also the profiles, and of course here you get into the adjustments. And this is the navigator, and some tools are in more than one category, but you can also set up your own. And this is where it gets interesting and where I want to put the focus on in this video. I have everything manually selected for my own workflow. And if you ever want to add tool, you can click on these buttons here, add a tool tab for custom tool tab, for example, and I'm going to show you how I set up mine in a second. And if you want to put another tool here, you just hit control on your keyboard, click here and add tool, and then you have all the tools that are available in Capture One. Okay, so let's switch workspace to what I work with, and this is the most recent one that allows me to work in the fastest and convenient, most convenient way. For example, most of the time I don't use all of these because I have my two favorite ones here. And starting with this one, of course, this shows the library and where everything is and how the things are rated. This one, in combination with this one, is most of the time what I use in my day-to-day. Of course, when I'm with a photographer and he's shooting tethered, that would be the one. Anyhow, let's go to the quick menu. And you can activate the quick menu by clicking these three dots. And you add the tool tab, which is called quick. That's for the Q. And the heart is my favorite. And you can use the custom tool tab and select your icon here. And there's the heart. And you can give it your name. All right. Since I already did that, I don't want to show you that. So what are we seeing here? As you can see, there is a bit more going on than on the regular one. That is because I want to have everything set right where I am. In this case, on the left side, there's all the tools. On the right side, there's the thumbnails of the story that I'm working on. This one is a story that has been shot by my friend and photographer Ava Pivot. And this was an editorial that we published in Faces magazine. All right. So as you can see, I pulled out the histogram because I want to have it visible at all times, because this is essential to make sure that all the tonal values are in balance. And this is a way to make sure that it does. You can also collapse it, of course. And I have added the adjustment clipboard just in case that I have adjustments copied that I want to apply to another image. I can check which ones are in the clipboard. Okay. Let me walk you through what I have selected as my essentials. That's the levels. All right. So if I want to work with the levels, I do it right here. The base characteristic, obviously, are the ones that are dependent on the camera used and the image. I have the white balance here. I have the exposure settings. I have the high dynamic range settings. And I do have the curves. These ones are the ones that I use in every image, no matter what. I love working with the curves. As you might have seen in my other recent videos, or the ones that were also when I had recordings with David Grover from Capture One, you can see that I'm color grading images with the curves in the channel separately. That is a way to go that I love very much. It offers so much control and gives you flexibility, and I like working like that. Of course, you don't have to do that, but it's optional. And there's the color editor, and the color editor is a very, very powerful tool as well. You can click the individual colors and use the eyedropper tool and just work with the colors individually on the image. For example, if you click here, you can see that it selects the yellows. And if you move from right to left on your Wacom board or with your mouse, you can see that you change the hue. And if you work on the saturation, you just go up and down. Okay, but this was just an example. Then I have a scrollable area. This is here because I have some things that I want to have at hand, but I don't use them all the time. So therefore, I have them in the scrollable area. And for example, this is the noise reduction. This is clarity. This is sharpening. And then you can see, you can scroll it, but these remain as they were. Styles and presets, film grain, I use a lot, black and white, cropping and smart adjustments. I have the layer palette taken out from the menu on the left side as well, because I want to make sure that I have access to the layers at all times, change the opacity, change the luminance masking, and therefore it's here. And another thing that I've pulled out, which I enjoy very much, is the color balance tool. If you have missed it on the left side, it's here. And I've added it three times. So by doing that, I can have control over the shadows, midtones, and highlights individually. And I can increase the size, which helps me a lot to have more control over... Let me just quickly change the size of this one and reattach this. I do have much more control over the individual points when I have it in a larger scale. And I can see, for example, how I grade the shadows, the midtones, and the highlights. Right? So that's one way. Of course, you can move it around to the left side when you use it. And then you can see what it does. By having it separated into three, I am in control over the tonal values, and I can implement a very subtle grading or an intense grading. And if I do that on a separate layer, I do, for example, create a new layer, call it color grade, and I'm going to fill the mask so that is completely visible. And then I can, for example, cool down the shadows a bit. I can warm the midtones and warm the highlights. And this way I have the color grade on a separate layer, which is quite subtle. Right, as you can see. And of course I can change the opacity, and I have very much control over this. So that is that. This is how I use Capture One with the quick menu. I want to show you the hard menu, so my favorites. I just have put the style brushes and the styles and presets there because I want to have them separately. And I really like to have my style brushes at hand. And I have a custom one, that's a Dodge and Burn brush, or you can use all the built-in ones, which are fantastic to enhance your image. For example, let me just take the Dodge one, start drawing. You will see that the layer is already created. And if I hit this again, I can show you that I can switch the size and the hardness, opacity, everything right on here. And of course, I can just paint on the image, for example, and show you the mask with hitting the letter M. And here you can see that style brushes can be used, for example, to dodge and burn, to enhance contrast. The color ones are also very interesting, or the enhancements where you have something like iris enhancing, red skin reduction, which work insanely good. I would encourage you to check it out. And with the styles, it's the same thing. You have the custom styles. That these are the ones that I created myself. And of course, the ones that I can, from other editorials and other photographers that have sent me their styles, I collect them here. And these are the ones that I can apply or having as a starting point to come into some kind of a creative flow, checking color grades, playing with images. That's why I have that separate section to have my styles and style brushes available and with a large overview. All right. I hope you found value in how I set up my Capture One. I'm very curious to hear your thoughts on this. Please put them in the comments. Let me know what you think. Let me know how you work with Capture One and what are your favorite tools. If you like, you can check out the next video, which is about how I set up my Wacom tablets. And if you haven't seen it yet, there's a video about Adobe Photoshop and another one on how I set up my ISO screens and how I calibrate the monitor. Thank you very much for watching. Please feel free to forward this video to someone you know that might benefit from it as well. And until then, see you next time. This was Jan. Bye.